please ensure that you say the right thing straight away, not asking question while you're making a statement. Not making a statement while you are asking a question. Everything must be age appropriate, putting their developmental stage in mind. I didn't check time before I started. Okay. I've seen that. Please, if you have any question, I think there is two chat. Please, I wouldn't mind just unmute and just stop me. If I'm going too fast, just let me know. Too slow, let me know.
You said 10 minutes.
All right. Too slow, let me know. Just right, just say, oh, yeah. Well done. All right. What makes a successful family? I have three important rules that I really like and I believe every good family should emulate. I call the three R's. Respect yourself and others. When you have a little child, you know, this starts from, it's not about, a lot of parents wait until their child is big and they start to complain. My child doesn't listen. I think in my head, a lot of time I get questions, I get parents calling me, my child doesn't listen to me, my child doesn't do this. Sometimes I just say, how did he get here? It doesn't just start from that moment. So it's very important. Let's just be careful while we make our rules and consequences. Respect yourself and others. When you ask a toddler or a little child or early years, what is respect? They will tell you, be nice. So let's keep it simple. Be nice. It's a family rule. Let's be nice. Be nice to yourself. Be nice to others. When these things are in place, these children are going to grow as giants, that they're going to bless the society, the world at large. It's a family rule. You can't say something else and be doing something different. It's very important. No parent, if you want to raise a very good family, if you want to protect your family, you cannot say something else and you are not following the rules. For me, my children, they are like police for me. If I make any mistake, they will tell me, mommy, parenting. So I'm always very conscious because they also know now that they will tell me straight away, mommy, parenting. I was a few weeks ago, I was just talking to my boy and I was like, precious, if you don't do that now, I'm going to lock you up. And he just looked at me, said, mommy, parenting essentials. And I said, okay, actually, I was just kidding. Because he knows I will never lock him up. So, you know, it's very good for us to teach our children, talk to them like adults. It helps them. It helps their brain. We are just helping them. Emotionally, they're going to be strong. Psychologically, they'll be ready for the world. They'll be ready for the community. They'll be ready for the world at large. So, please, tell them, respect yourself, respect others. It means be nice. Parents also need to respect themselves and respect others. Respect properties. I see parents, I'll say, oh, my child is going to throw it. Before I had my children are 5 years now. And before I had them, a lot of people would tell me when they come to my house, like, oh yeah, it's because you don't have them, you don't understand. And I said, I do understand. No, when you have babies, you will understand. By the time you come to your house, you're always complaining, your child is throwing the couch, your child is throwing the cushion. And I said, I do understand. But they said, no, you will see. And I told them something. I remember telling somebody something. I said, you will also see that I'm going to teach my children not to touch the things. Because they were really waiting to say, okay, we will see. You are always complaining. People don't understand. They say he's too young. He's too old. There is no time that he's too young or too old. You start teaching your child from day one. If you want to get a good result, from the moment the child is coming out from your tummy, you start the work. Parenting starts. From tracking the height, from checking the hearing, parenting starts. The mannerism and the gesture you want your children to have starts from the day one. So I said to those people, I said, you will see. And by the grace of God, I don't know, I believe in God. Sorry, pardon me if that is offensive to you. By the grace of God, my children never touched what I did not ask them to touch. Because I was very conscious of it, that parenting is a personal call. You do what you want them to do. You teach them, except for a special needs child. And if somebody's having a special needs child, I believe in early intervention. At the same time, it starts from the beginning. The more you intervene from the beginning, early intervention is the key. Everything is possible, even if it's an autistic child. Training is a psychology. Pavlov is a psychology. You just have to tune the brain. This is the way it should go. And whatever you train them, it sticks. So, train your child that respect property, taking care of stuff. from little things, a lot of things are just overlooked. People overlook things. Your child is throwing things around the house. Just it's okay. It's a child. Only 2 years. Only 3 years. Please teach your children. Let parents teach their children. Please spread the news that children must be taught how to take care of stuff. You know, corruption that we are shouting today. It doesn't start from today. It starts long time ago from people, from little things. I've been to the mall before and I saw some children picking chocolates, keeping it to themselves, and I saw their parents looking at them. Okay, just go there, we don't pay. What is that? Corruption, parenting. You know, when something happens, when they grow up and something, they can't control anymore. Oh, how did we get here? My child is now boggling the house. The parents will forget. When I saw her telling the children to pick chocolate and go away. So this thing starts from day one. We can't wait. We can't wait to have a very good family, to protect our family. We cannot wait. It starts from day one. Respecting authority. This is another very important point. You know, a lot of people that use babysitter, maybe teachers, especially babysitter. If you have a nanny in the house, a lot of people forget to teach their children that at the moment that they are not home, the nanny or the babysitter is an authority. So we have to teach our children. I've had a lot of people work with me before. I've been privileged to have a lot of PAs before. Nobody will know that they are even working for me because they are authority. Even my children, they cannot say, no, they are authority. And these are the mistakes, the common mistakes in families and in parenting. They think this is a nanny. No, we are one big family. So they are forgetting something, that this one, by the end of the day, by the time it's going to become a big issue, it's going to be a big problem. Please, every parent should teach their children to respect authority, teachers, and the law. I'm just going to go fast. The time is gone. Communicate well. Make communication a priority. Communication also starts from day one. By the time you have your baby, start communicating, track it. I tell people, we say, no, yeah, why are you telling me that? It's just 1 week. 1 week is not too early. I start doing second time for my children from day one. Take your time. We're going to have that prayer time tomorrow. We're going to sing that nursery song together. We're going to read together. It's a communication skill. People ask me today, how come your children can talk like that? I say, no, communication is the key. You have to teach them. A lot of children that have speech delay that I've experienced, I've been able to work with special needs kids in the past. But however, if I trace, trying to do my tracking on what the problem was, is because the communication wasn't good enough. And why? Because the parents are not even aware what they're supposed to do. They are not aware. And this is the main problem we have, parenting, building family. A lot of people just jump into the sea without knowing how to swim. So how do you correct that? What you don't know, you cannot teach. This is a problem. So we are now going to do the work by telling people, by educating people that were close to us, any privilege that we have, that communication is the key. Never shut your child up. Let them say their mind. If all these things are in place, even the risk of abuse is very low. You teach them to be confident, you teach them to be able to express their mind, let them have their self-esteem. The risk of abuse is going to be very, very minimal. Make communication a priority. Have a clear role. It's very important to have a clear role. This is your job. I'm going out, everybody, make sure you clean the house and everything. It's not going to work like that. Ensure the roles are clear. This is what you're supposed to do and everything. I will not go without touching about couples rebranding. Rebranding here that I put here is not for the children only. It's for the entire family. Don't forget that you are parent as role model to their children. A lot of parents, they are complaining, why is my child like this going out to fight? But they're forgetting, even if they're not beating themselves in the house, the words that are coming out of their mouth, the couple, like daddy and mommy, is very terrible. It's very important to be conscious and to rebrand. Let the kids see that this house is love. Let them see what, you know, the psychology can be corrected, can be seen. Even if they're seeing what is going on, environmental factor. Yeah, in that place, my friend told me that their parents are fighting. But they will say, but my own parents are not fighting every time. They never fought. They are just sharing love. So it's always good for us to rebrand and let the children see that, you know, love should be shared. There is this different love of husband and wife. Let them see. My children are 5 years, but they know that mommy and daddy loves each other so much. They can explain to you. They can even teach an adult. They understand that they love themselves so much. We always rebrand our love. We let them see that why we have to take care of ourselves and things like that. Also rebrand them the time, the parenting time with their children. Let them see you as a very good time giver. Let them see you as a provider. Please, it's very important for you to rebrand.
She works maybe on Facebook, the Vision Guide. If you check her check our page on Facebook, The Vision Guy. You will know that I'm not speaking against her. You will know I'm giving you a food. Maybe that part, we didn't put it in our profile, that she's very active. We just placed the education profile there. So go to The Vision Guy on Facebook. That's our work. And you even see our children and everything there. So you look that they run, it runs in their blood. To be very active. Ms. Soye, we appreciate you. We appreciate you.
Thank you very much.
Hello, sir.
Yes. Mommy,
so is it still Ms. Soye that's taking the safeguarding children?
Yes. No. Oh. Now. Safeguarding children is another set of people, your colleagues. They are in the same system with you.
I want to know if it is Ms. Soye, the vision guy.
Yes. She's one.
Okay, all right.